Three, two, one.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Friday and I hope you have something amazing planned for this weekend. I am going to Uchu for this weekend and going to pamper myself silly. But before I go away, let's check out today's riddle. If a red house is built with red bricks and a yellow house is built with yellow bricks, with what is a greenhouse built? The answer at the end of the show.
We've been talking about this thing called love. Probably something you've been dreaming of. It's a perfect sometime. It's a perfect sometime. You always get me. You
The annual Roundtables Winter Night project aimed at raising funds for marginalized communities and the vulnerable was a resounding success for another year, with the main focus being to raise donations to ensure these communities are assisted in whichever way possible during the cold winter months. The Winter Nights can boast multiple success stories. This was the 18th year that the Winter Nights campaign united communities through the giving and receiving of blankets, clothing, food and donations that not only warm bodies, but also the hearts of all involved. The success of this campaign lies in the passion of the Namibian business sector and its individuals who braved the cold to personally collect donations on the morning of 3 June across multiple street corners in Windhoek, Walvis Bay and Swakopmund. This year's total project value so far is in excess of $1.1 million, of which $573,000 was in cash. Final recons on the latter amount are still in progress as the Knights continue receiving donations. The true measure of success is not the record amount of donations raised, but the hope that the donations and distributions make a difference to the beneficiaries' lives, however small it might be, says 2022 convener Stefan Duran. We would like to thank the communities from Windhoek, Walvis Bay and Swakopmund who made this fundraising project a huge success. Following the commemoration of International Albinism Awareness Day earlier this week, the Namibian support body, SINASRA, hosts the local event at the Disability Resource Center in Okreangawa on Saturday. Albinism is a non-contagious, genetically inherited condition that affects people regardless of race, ethnicity, or gender. The condition is a worldwide issue where people with albinism, or PWA, tend to stand out because of their skin color and hair. Albinism potentially results in two major health conditions, namely visual impairment and high vulnerability to skin damage from ultraviolet rays, which includes skin cancer. Although people with albinism represent a small segment of the population globally, they are the most affected by poverty, particularly in developing countries. In addition, they face multiple forms of discrimination on the basis of their disability and color. Notwithstanding the different human rights situation of people with albinism worldwide, certain challenges are common throughout all regions due to misconceptions of the condition. Across the world, people with albinism suffer from discrimination, stigmatization, and social exclusion. In some countries, particularly in Africa, the physical appearance of people with albinism has been the object of erroneous beliefs and myths influenced by superstition, witchcraft, or both. These myths have fostered marginalization, social exclusion, and physical attacks, amongst others. Related harmful practices include accusations of witchcraft, killing, rape, trafficking in persons, and trafficking in body parts, amongst others. In this regard, there have been reports of attacks carried out in African countries like Malawi, Nigeria, Kenya, Tanzania, and South Africa, to mention just a few. The latest incident in Namibia was when two men approached a person living with albinism, asking him to sell them his hair. It is against the background of incidents like these that on 18 December 2014, the United Nations General Assembly adopted a resolution proclaiming that with effect from 2015, 13 June would be International Albinism Awareness Day. This is mainly due to the fact that people with albinism are entitled to civil, political, economic, and social rights. This year's theme is United in Making Our Voice Heard, which was chosen to celebrate how groups of PWAs and individuals can increase the visibility of people living with a condition in all domains of life and to encourage and celebrate unity amongst them. In Namibia, the day will be celebrated under the umbrella of the Support in Namibia for Albinism Sufferers Requiring Assistance, which is SANASTRA. The aim is to foster a culture of socializing and information sharing within the albinism community and the general public, and importantly, to bring people living with albinism together in order to create a sense of belonging and to alleviate isolation, because knowing others in the same situation is helpful. Namibia se Samuel Nelson Odisi het geslaag vir deelname aan die Hubert van der Spuy Nasionale Musiekkompetisie in Suid-Afrika. Die jong pianist ding vanaf 23 tot 30 September in Kaapstad teen 32 ander musici om die laure mee. Die kompetisie is tans die enigste van sy soort in Suid-Afrika en bied 'n unieke geleentheid vir kinders van 13 jaar en jonger om teen hulle ewe knieë van reg oor die land mee te ding. Verskeie vorige wenners van die kompetisie het nie net musiek op tersiêre vlak gaan studeer nie, maar het ook al selfs internasionaal bekroonde kunstenaars en opvoeders geword. By geleentheid het ander teruggekeer na die kompetisie as gerekende lede van die jurypaneel. Die streng program wat van deelnemers vereis word, verseker dat 'n hoë standaard gehandhaaf word, terwyl dit aan hulle platform bied vanwaar hulle onskatbare prestasieervaring kan opdoen. The Namibian Electronic Sports Association, or NESA, hosts its second qualifying round in the PlayStation titles Tekken 7 eFootball and PUBG Mobile on Saturday. This follows hot on the heels of the first qualifying round that took place only a few weeks ago. Athletes should bring their A-game to show that they have what it takes to represent Namibia at the next eWorld Sports Championships. This qualifier will be held at the MTC Innovation Center at Marua Mall, right next to the MTC Mobile home. Athletes who wish to sign up can do so at the esportsnamibia.org website and just follow the NESA 22 qualifiers registration form. However, they will need to do so by the end of today. NESA thanks its official esports partner MTC, as well as Logitech and Nanodoc for making these events possible. They also thank all the volunteers and staff who put in lots of effort to make this happen.
3, 2, 1.
Here we go! Over the next week, it's carnival time in Swakopmund. The fun kicks off with the Prinsen Bowl on Friday and continues until the 25th, with a variety of events mostly taking place at the Haas der Jugend, all starting at the magical hour of 11 minutes past 8. Tickets are available at Mutts and Mules in the town. On Friday at 10 a.m. there's a Justice for Animals and CrossFit live charity throwdown at the Holy Geingob Stadium, with entertainment by Rian Smith, Jacob and Taylor and Half Jack, along with fun for the kids and a variety of stalls. The fun continues on Saturday as from 10 a.m. On Saturday at 10, you can meet South African motivational speaker Cindy Swanepoel at Lemon Tree in Windhoek when she speaks of thankfulness and new opportunities. At the same time, a family fun day takes place at the MTC Dome in Swakopmund with a tasting of beers, wines and cheese while the kids can prepare their own pizza along with dancing on the deck with Andrea. And at 2 that afternoon, there's a dance workshop hosted by the Umbetje Yahinga organization at the Franco-Namibian Cultural Center.
Kijkers, vandag gesels ek met Zoe en Zoe het begin Easy Sales. Vertel vir ons van jou besigheid.
Baie dankie dat ek die geleentheid gekry het om vandag bietjie te kan gesels oor my besigheid. Ek het Easy Sales begin want ek neem die jaar deel aan Mistie Namibia en ek het besef ek gaan moet paar van die uitgawes self moet dek. Ek kan nie net heeltyd voor by my ma so bakkant staan nie. So ek het besluit ek moet iets verkoop waarin ek vertrou en wat by my en my verwysingsraamwerk pas. So ek het die aand na my fotosessie vir my Steen my Wild Jude lappie gebruik en toe was ek soos light bulb moment. Hoekom verkoop ek nie dit nie?
Ek self gebruik die lappie en ek gebruik dit al vir 'n jaar en dit is ongelooflik. Daai make-up wat jy altyd wil hê moet vir 16 of 18 ure hou vir ja. Al lipstifie. Dis ongelooflik want daai lappie haal dit af.
Ja. Want soos daai dag vir my fotosessie, ek het al 6:00 die oggend was het hare en grimering. En dit moes die hele dag hou. Ons het ons onderhoude gehad, ons het ons foto's gehad. En ek, toe ek daai aand by die huis kom, toe die make-up het nog gesit. So ek het toe my lappie uitgehaal, warm water en net so afgehaal. En soos die ooggrimering, dis bietjie swaarder, so maar dan hou net bietjie langer en daar was dit af. Maklik so dit.
Presies. Vertel vir my, gaan jy ander produkte ook begin verkoop?
Ek stel belang om nog verdere produkte by Easy Sales te verkoop. Ek het al 2 agente gehad wat belang gestel het omdat ek ook hulle produkte vir hulle kan verkoop. Maar dis nou eers 'n geheim. Maar ek wil net eers begin het met een produk om soos my voet nou in die besigheidswêreld. Ek wou nie myself en my kliënte verwar nie, so ek het maar net begin met een produk sover, ja.
Vertel vir ons, het jy 'n Facebook page waar mense jou kan kontak?
Ek het nog nie 'n Facebook page nie. Ek het wel 'n Instagram page. Ek het nog nie enigiets daarop geplaas nie. Ek wag net tot dit genoeg followers kry. Want laat ek nou net eers eksamen deurkom. En sodra dit vakansie is, gaan ek nou meer begin daarop plaas, meer foto's before after die verskillende kleurvariasies wat mens kan koop en definitief later 'n Facebook kry. Ja.
Vertel gou vir ons, hoekom het jy besluit om hierdie jaar vir my van Tina Namibia in te skryf?
Ek het besef dat ek moet bietjie out of my comfort zone stap en my boundaries push. Ek wil graag nie net groei as 'n mens nie, maar ook 'n impak probeer maak vir die Namibiese mense. Ek het my social responsibility cause is bloedskenk en ek wil graag meer mense, spesifiek die jonger mense van Namibië, motiveer om aktiewe bloedskenkers te word. En Mevrou Tiener Namibië gee vir my 'n baie groot platform om dit te kan doen en my boodskap vir ander mense te kan deel.
Dis eintlik so 'n belangrike ding om bloed te skenk,
ja.
want hulle het altyd 'n tekort en nou, om jong ja. mense betrokke te kry is ongelooflik.
Namibië is nou in 'n kritiese bloedtekort en minder as 1% van die Namibiese populasie skenk bloed.
Sure.
So dit is daarom belangrik om meer mense te motiveer, want een donasie kan 3 lewens red. En ek is trots om te sê dat ek nou al 7 donasies gedoen het.
Wow.
En dit is altyd lekker om meer mense saam te nooi, vriende, en dan maak jy iets lekker daarvan.
Wat het jy nou al in hierdie tydperk geleer vandat jy ingeskryf het vir my Fatina?
Ek het geleer dat ek is eintlik sterk. Ek was aan die begin bang, maar ek is genoeg. Ek kan dit doen. En daai selfvertroue wat mens bou, groei net elke dag. En ek het geleer dat 'n positiewe mindset is wat mens nodig het. Harde werk, positiewe mindset, initiatief, dis die effort wat daarin insit. Hoeveel werk jy daarin insit, hoe beter resultate jy gaan kry. So ek werk hard elke dag, want as ek die titel as mevrou Tiener Namibia wil hê, moet ek committed wees.
Hoe lyk die tydlyn van nou af? Wanneer gebeur wat met mevrou Tiener?
Ons het nog nie enige vaste datums gekry nie, maar hulle beplan om in Julie die top 10 aan te kondig. En in die einde Julie gaan hulle die kroning. Dit gaan saam met Miss Namibia, Miss Teen en Miss Namibia gaan op dieselfde naweek wees. So alles hopelik Julie, Augustus.
Besige naweek daar.
Besig.
Wat sal dit vir jou beteken om top 10 te behaal?
Wel, dit sal beteken dat ek staan nog 'n kans om te kan wen. Dit sal vir my beteken dat die werk wat ek so ver ingesit het, was genoeg. En dat dit gaan nog net nog meer moeite vat, maar ek is reg vir dit. Ek voel ek is nou reg. Ek's reg vir dit. En elke dag groei en oefen, maar ek om in die top 10 te kan wees en homselfs om daai aand daar te kan wees, gaan vir my baie beteken.
Het jy baie nuwe vriendskappe gebou tydens hierdie uitstappie?
Definitief. Ons is 21 deelnemers. Sure. En 2 van hulle ken ek. Ek het al vorige keer saam met hulle te doen gehad, maar dis altyd lekker om nuwe mense te ontmoet. En paar van die meisies is reg baie oulik. Toe ons fotosessie gehad het, daar was paar wat nou nie daar was nie, maar ons gaan definitief een of ander tyd weer almal saamkom en net weer kan lekker gesels.
Ag, dis lekker en dis lekker as dit 'n groep jong meisies is wat goed oor die weg kom en almal se einddoel is om 'n verskil om op een of ander manier in die samelewing te maak.
Almal het wel verskillende organisasies wat hulle ondersteun of so iets soos dit, maar ons is almal daar om 'n verskil te maak. Ons is daar om 'n impak te maak. En ek is bly dat ons kan saam dit almal saam doen, ja.
Ek wil gaan nou terugkom na die lappies toe wat jy gekoop. Vertel vir my watse kleure het jy beskikbaar?
Die Wow Jude lappies kom in 'n verskeidenheid kleure, maar ek hou net 10 van die kleure aan. Dit is maar net die 10 mees algemene kleure vir mans, vrouens, babas, kinders, tieners en iets wat almal sal van hou. Maar as iemand nou wel 'n groot maat bestelling sou plaas vir 'n spesifieke kleur, sal ek dit natuurlik vir hulle kan kry.
En vertel my, is dit, jy het jou net genoem babas en mans en almal, kan jy dit gebruik op klein kinders se velle?
Ja, want die lappie is van 'n microfiber materiaal gemaak. So as 'n baba nou soos die verbrandboutjies of 'n tiener meisie of seun se vel, dit kan vir dit gebruik word, want dit hoef nie net vir grimering nie. Dit kan net of jy wil net jou gesig was. Ja.
En die lekker gedeelte daarvan is jy het net warm water nodig. Jy het nie nodig om enige produkte op die lappie te sit om jou grimering af te haal nie.
Ja.
Nee. So, baie baie dankie dat jy met my kom gesels het.
Baie dankie.
Baie sterkte vir die top 10 en vir die kroning en maak seker jy gebruik daai platform.
Ek sal, baie dankie.
Kijkers, daar het julle dit. As julle wil Wow Jude lappies bestel, sou wees die meisie om dit by te doen.
Headed over to Netflix once again, and we are looking at amazing vacation rentals, and this is just fantastic because they look at different budgets, which is something that doesn't always happen. So let's check out the series trailer of the first season.
This is just unreal.
Are you ready to start traveling the world once again? We are going to show you the most amazing way to do it.
All right, wow, what a place.
There are over 3 million vacation rentals at your fingertips. They come in all shapes and sizes.
Look at that!
This is crazy and weird, and I'm into it.
I'm a DIY designer. I'm gonna be your guide to budget-friendly rentals.
Wow. I've traveled to over 50 countries. I'm gonna take you off the beaten path to show unique vacation rentals.
Gorgeous.
I've been selling high-end real estate in New York. I will show you the most beautiful luxury vacation rentals around the world.
You see that house on top of the cliff?
I can't believe you can rent this.
The beauty about staying in our vacation rentals is it's not just about the house. It's about what you get access to by staying in the house.
This allows you to hang out with locals.
How is this a real place?
Yeah, I ordered something for you guys. Yeah, some breakfast.
Luis, this is so extra.
Whoa, crazy.
You don't need a lot of money to have a great time.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Wow. Right there.
I will never look at a vacation rental the same way again.
One, two, three. Ow!
You guys, the beauty we get to see.
Off to our next adventure.
Mm-hmm.
Today's life hack is for all the moms out there whose toddlers thinks the walls is a good place to write on, like mine does. You can remove crayon marks with a hairdryer. Next up, Jeanette Deerhart with your Flex Minute.
Hi everyone and welcome back to Flex Minutes. I'm Jeanette Deerhart, your presenter for Flex. Now today, I'll be showing you guys glued bridges. Now listen, they look easy, they seem easy, but they are not easy when you amp it up a bit more. So if you feel like your workout is getting too easy or you're getting comfortable in it, don't worry, you can always take it a level further. All right, so I'm gonna show you guys what you can do. So on our backs, glued bridges. Glued bridges. You're just lifting up and you're squeezing those glutes, guys. That is what we're doing here. This is the basic one, all right? So for you beginners, you can do this. You can start with your glute bridge, but now let's take it up a notch, all right? So lift up that leg and there you go. There you have a glute workout where you don't need to squat, where you don't need to pick up any weight. And you're just working on those cheeks, guys. So obviously alternating between the two legs and hold it there. So if you wanna take it a level up, hold it there for a few seconds, even for a minute if you wanna do that, and or you can pulse it. For modifications, you can have it in a figure four position and you lift and you squeeze. Constantly squeezing, guys, squeezing those glutes, because if you don't squeeze it now, nobody would want to squeeze it later. But that brings us to the end of today's Flex Minute. I hope to see you next time.
So, can you tell me if a red house is built with red bricks and a yellow house is built with yellow bricks, what is a greenhouse made of? Glass. I hope you have a great weekend. I will be back with new interviews and a recommendation on Monday morning. Goodbye.